Friends, here we are discussing about BOTO3 collections concept of resource object. See, collections concept is slightly different in your client object. We'll discuss about it in our later videos. And BOTO3 collections are useful to collect group of resources information. And here I'm explaining about this concept by taking an example called EC2 service. But you can apply same concept for any of your AWS service. Now, let me open my Sublime text editor. Suppose I want to explain this concept with EC2 service. So let me create EC2 console. So for that, first I am creating AWS management console equals to BOTO3.session.session profile name. You can take any profile. Then let me create EC2 console using resource object, because we are working with collections concept of resource. Then AWS management console dot resource, then provide your service name equals to EC2, then region name US East 1 suppose. Now let me open your AWS management console once. See, this is EC2 console. Then what are group of resources? See, in your AWS EC2 console, you can work with instances or instance types, or let me go with images or volumes or snapshots or security groups. All these things are group of resources. Now collectively, to collect all these group of resources, you have to use collections concept. Now let me open your BOTO3 official documentation. And let me navigate into your EC2 service. So available services, go to EC2 and select your service resource. Open that. We know that in our resource object, we have three set of operations: set 1, set 2, and set 3. Set 3 are related to collections. And see here, what are the group of services you can collect by using resource collections on your EC2 console. See, you can collect all these group of resources. Suppose if you want to work with images or instances or volumes or subnet snapshot, just click on that. Suppose I want to collect instances, then click on that instances. Now first let me create your instances collection object. See, simply directly I am printing from your EC2 console resource object. I am creating instances collection object. Now just run it and see the output. This is an object. See the list of operations on this. See that you are getting some output. So in that you have these many sub methods on your collection object. This is collection object. On this object you can apply all these sub methods. And as of now, just try to concentrate on all, filter, and limit. We'll discuss about remaining options in our next session, next video. Fine. Now let me make a note on this. So on instances collection object, we are discussing about all, limit, then filter. So first let me go with all and limit. Simply you have to do operation called dot all. Dot all. Even these operations you can find in your console, in your document itself. See, instances object, it is having all, create tags, right, filter. So all options are available here also, but you can easily get from your command line itself. Now let me save it and run it. See the output. Again you are getting an object, but this is an iterator. So simply all means you are going to collect all your EC2 instances from your particular region of your EC2. Now for each in, simply print each. Anyway, this dot all is going to collect all your EC2 instances. That's why you are going to get three instances, because on my AWS EC2 console under your US East 1, I have three instances. That's why it is collecting. That's fine. So whenever if you want to collect all your EC2 instances, you are using option sub method called all. But I want to limit. I want to get only, suppose assume that you are having some 100 EC2 instances in a particular region. I want to get top 10. I mean the order. So first 10 I want to get. Then you can use simply limit. Limit. I want to get 10. Of course, I have only 3. That's why just I have taken 2. Limit to 2. And now see the output. Anyway, this option is not useful very much in your real time. No problem. But you have an option. That's fine. Now the important operation or sub method on your collection object is always filter. First, let me apply filter and see the output. You are getting all your EC2 instances. It's like exactly equals to all. But using this filter sub method on your collection object, you have a lot of advantages. Let me show you by opening your documentation. See that this is a filter. So now filter is taking some arguments. So as of now, I am not touching about the remaining arguments. I am touching with only filters. And be clear, this filters is an argument for your dot filter method, and this filters is a list, and this list consists of, be clear, a dictionary. And you can write here any number of dictionaries here. Each dictionary is like one filter. So just for your understanding purpose, I am making a simple syntax. So filters equals to list. And in this list, you can apply any number of filters. Now let me create my first filter. So filter one, you can take any variable name here. I'm taking simply F1. So what is the purpose to create filters first? See, in my console, EC2 console, I have three instances, out of which two instances are stopped. Then I want to display only running instances. I want to display only running. I want to collect the information about running instances. I don't want to collect the information about stopped instances. Then you need to filter your instances. For that, you have to use this filter. For that, you have to use your sub-resource sub-method called filter. For that, you have to apply argument called filters, and that filter is a list. In this filter, you can apply any number of filters. First, let me create one filter, F1. And whatever the filters you are going to apply in the list, that is a dictionary. See that? This is a dictionary. And this dictionary consists of standard key called name and key called values. And name is a string. You can provide your required name here, and values. Based on this name, you have to provide value here. Now, I am taking this entire thing as a filter one. So filter one is a dictionary. So in that, you have standard key called name, and you have to provide the name here. We'll provide it, comma, values. This is the standard keys in your filters. Then values or list of values again. Don't get confused. Just follow this syntax so that it will be very easy to apply filters for your collections filter method. Now my requirement is I want to list running instances. Then what is the name I can provide here, and what is the value I can provide here? Just go down. See, some these all are name values. Whatever the name is there, right? You have to provide some string here. So you can select any one of the string from here. Already they have. So as of now, what we need? Instant state name. So just search somewhere. Yeah, here we have instant state name. Let me take it, copy and paste it here. Then values. So what are the instances state name you need? Are running instances, or pending, or running and pending, or running and terminated? So all values are there directly here itself. Now I am taking running. Now let me take my value as running. Not only one value, you can provide any number of values inside of your values list. As of now, first let me apply this F1 and see the output. How many instances you are getting? you are going to get only one instance, that is 6f. See that 6f is currently running. Now assume that in your EC2 console you have running instances, stopped instances, some pending state instances, some terminated, but I want to display running and stopped. Then see here itself we have one more value, stopped. Copy it, and your values itself you can apply running comma values, sorry, running comma stop. That's it. Now let me save it and run it. Now you are going to get three instances. That's it. Now my requirement is, this is one filter. I want to get the instances which are running and which are t2.micro instance type. Then you have to take one more filter and take name as instance type and apply your required value there. See, let me take one more filter here. Likewise, you can create any number of filters. So anyway, while creating your filter, first of all, just follow this syntax. Name you have to provide here, comma, values. Values is a list. Take, this is the syntax. Now name, what is your name? So my requirement is, I need to filter the running and stopped instances which are under t2.micro instance type. So to get your running and stopped, this is the filter. And to filter your t2.micro, you have to take name as instance type, and here you have to provide t2.micro. Guys, don't get confused. Somewhere I am taking double quotations, somewhere I am taking single quotations. You can take any quotations, no problem. Now save it. F2, apply here, comma F2, F1, comma F2. Now you are filtering based on F1 and F2 filters. So what is F1? To get running and stopped. What is F2? To get t2.micro. Now intersection part you are going to get. Now see the output. Right? So this is the very, very important concept to collect your group of resources. So filters or filter method is very, very important on your collection object. Okay, we'll discuss about your remaining operations on your collections in the next session. Okay, thank you.